bigger and better than last year. I'm Mark Phelan, and today I'm joined in the commentary box by Ray Stevens. Ray, one of the gurus of European badminton. Ray, very good to have you here.
Thanks, Mark. Really looking forward to the match.
On this, we've already had qualification, men's singles, women's singles, and some doubles qualification, but main draw starting this evening, round of 64, of course, in the men's singles. And our first match on court at 5:30 in just a few minutes' time will be between Denmark's, as you can see it popping up on screen, Rasmus Fladberg, and the German giant Dieter Domke. Some history between these players, played twice. And it's the head-to-head's a piece, so playing for some bragging rights here for sure. Fladberg has been dogged by injury over the last 2 years. Only recently at the Belgian International had to pull out of his first round match. So a tough time for the Dane. Of course, Rasmus Fladberg, winner of a European Junior medal in 2011, if I remember correctly, in men's doubles, as it was. And against Dieter Domke. Domke, the giant from Germany, as I said, world rank 101. And winner of the bronze medal at the recent European Games in Baku. In a cracking game against Peter Kukal that went to three games in the heat and the intensity in Baku.
Rasmus Fladberg actually comes from really good stock because world's men's doubles champion in 1983 and a bit of a legend.
As you can see, the players emerging from the tunnel. Fladberg in front in red, Domke in black. And as you said, quite rightly, Ray, champion, and certainly in my opinion, Rasmus in his younger days, as he proved in the European Juniors, winning a doubles, men's doubles, alongside Kim Astrup, who's gone on to better things for Denmark. And stuck it out at doubles, but he likes singles, and delightful young man, of course, very approachable, very easy to talk to, and like all the Danes, they have perfect English.
And have father so well, it's really from the same stock, you can see that, they look so similar.
Yeah, short and stocky, yeah. And full of power in the upper legs. Domke, being the traditional German national team attire, and that is because he's outside of the German national team right now and currently looking for a sponsor. So certainly this season and since the beginning of the Badminton Europe circuit, you've seen him wearing this black outfit in every single match.
And a very tall lad, isn't he?
Yeah, pushing 2 meters, not quite as tall as even off of Russia, but still very, very tall and very dominant when you see that large frame in front of you. And you know, it's been an up and down time of late for Dieter Domke. And Dieter is one of those players, in my opinion, who really, really has great skills and good racket skills, but has sometimes this mental block and is unable to put 5 matches together in a tournament to win. Can play fantastic up to a semi-final and a quarter-final. I remember seeing him at my own Irish Open 2 or 3 years back into the final. And, you know, you really would have put your house on him to win that. But, you know, something happened in the
fire games because he's got the ability to reach a very high standard. Very awkward player to play against because he's got such good angles.
Yeah, seriously steep angles coming off those smashes, and you have to be careful against them. But also quite a thoughtful player on court. And with some silky skills and short, stocky, very much, as you said, Ray, like his dad. Best results for Fladberg recently. He was runner-up at the Spanish International, which was just at the beginning of the summer, beaten on that occasion by the home favourite, Pablo Abion. But as I said, he's been dogged by injury this season. Kharkiv International got to the quarter-final, a tournament that he has won before. That beaten in the first round, as I said, at the Belgian International, went out with injury. The Dutch Open, Denmark Open, his own Premier Super Series, beaten in the first round. and then a very disappointing round of 64 loss at the Bitburger Open. So not great form for the Dane. Domke, on the other hand, just got a round further at the, but again, it's been a less than illustrious year for the tall German. Semi-final at the Spanish International, his best recent result. So they're ready to go. Domke, furthest from the camera in black, serving to Fladberg in red. A nice way to start with a backhand winner, Ray.
Absolutely. Holding the net, looking for attack. And I think that's going to be the trademark, really, of what he's trying to do in this match. Is he's going to try and gain the net and attack Fladberg. But I think Fladberg is a real rally master. I think he could be...
Yeah, again, I think, again, a lot will depend on Rasmus and his fitness, and sometimes with injury comes that mental block and then the inability to come back. While you may have physically recovered, you still lag a little bit behind with the mental preparation. And is my injury okay? How am I feeling? So we will know. And that's a nice cross court smash, and that's one of those steals from Domke. From the German.
And Dieter's really come out firing, but it's hard to carry that all the way through, to keep on. And what happens is, with someone like Rasmus, they rally you, and then make a bite into your ability to keep on attacking them.
Good point from the German, pushing Fladberg back into his deep backhand corner, and then sensing the short returning, following it up. Very explosive coming forward, too, for such a tall man. That's beautiful, deceptive return from Fladberg. Just seemed to be a little bit off balance on the initial smash down the line, the Dane. And then Domke really exploiting that open court.
I definitely get the impression here that Fladberg's going for the long game, and that Dieter's looking for the short game to try and blast him off the court as quickly as he possibly can. But
again, you see the effectiveness of the reach of the taller man. Yeah, easy net kill in the end for the German. Change of shuttle required. And just some court maintenance from the Dane. Of course, we're in the Emirates Arena, this fantastic arena, which was home. The Commonwealth Games seems like a dip. That's a poor chips. So certainly an opportunity for some of these players to get used to the arena. These big arenas generally bring with them a little bit of drift.
Yeah, there's a drift there today. Fladberg is up the slow end, when Dieter's heading into Fladberg, it's easier to rally, whereas it's easier actually for Rasmus to attack Dieter, but it's Dieter that's doing most of the attacking at the moment.
Yeah, interval lead and a commanding interval lead, 11-3. It was pretty tight at the beginning, 2-all, 3-2, but Fladberg, you can see, it's just that look. It's not a confident look. The body language is just a little bit negative. can just see in the shot behind Hans-Kristian Vittinghus, who's playing on the adjoining court.
Actually looked a slightly different pace.
Court one, 20 seconds. 11, 3, play.
Good deception on the return of serve.
Four,
it's going to take, and then goes with the flick against the tall German. Risky strategy. But Dieter looks comfortable, Ray.
It does, he looks, and he particularly looks comfortable around the net when he's around the net area. I think really Rasmus got the much tougher job trying to get past the big man, whereas Dieter's able to play a lot easier and find the gaps. But I think it's early days. Even for this quality of singles, it's early days, and anything can happen. Certainly, when you get this sort of lead, it favours Dieter Domke for this first set. But I really feel that if Rasmus Fladberg could get into the rallies and make him work hard, then you can see a dramatic change.
A little bit of indecision from Rasmus. You could see the shuttle hitting the net on the serve and it looked to be clearly landing short. But still that indecision, and he ended up playing it. Sometimes in the mind is not in sync with the body. Better return. And there's a stick smash from the small, from the tall man, but then an error at the net. Uncharacteristic, it has to be said, in this game.
Yeah, pushed a big stroke in there.
Yeah, around the head.
That is over.
Finding the deep forehand corner. 15-6 ahead, the German in black.
And he's making it look incredibly comfortable against a player of real quality when he's on form.
Good steep angle on the initial smash from such a small man. And then following it up at the net. Nice little soft net shot from Fladberg. And remember, if you're watching and you want to get involved, and you want to make comment, and you want to get say something about the match, say something about the commentary, don't forget to use the hashtag, as you can see appearing up near top right hand corner, SOGP Scottish Open Grand Prix. We'd be delighted to hear what you have to say. Some excitement here earlier in the qualification rounds of the men's doubles. The Grimley brothers getting through to the main draw, which is exciting certainly for Scottish badminton.
19,
they're only 15, Mark, which is...
Yeah, they look the real deal. It's just about keeping them grounded, I think, as they move forward.
8,
what I love about them is they enjoy their badminton. Here's an extended rally, and this I feel this will work in Fladberg's favour to get the rallies going, get the strength away from the big man.
Yeah, I think Rasmus certainly had the opportunity on the second or third stroke in that rally with a smash and elected to play somewhat of a soft drop, and still coming out the end of the rally with the point, even though he's trailing 8-19, it looks like he's beginning to get a little bit of a foothold in the game.
Yep.
Starting to find a rhythm. That's a good smash. Lift was only half court, but still well pulled away by a Fladberg. 11 minutes gone. And you can kind of sense, and this is the issue I have with Dieter, and I spoke about this earlier in the commentary. He has these moments where he just switches off and loses concentration, and I think his string went that on that occasion. But still, from being in a thoroughly commanding position, still leading by 8 points, of course, it's Rasmus Fladberg who's just looking a little bit more comfortable, and there's another unforced error from the German.
I think at 12-19 he's left himself a little bit too much to do in this particular set, and it's now 13-19, but I think it's 6 points is a lot when you're on a rally scoring system. To me, this all started from some extended rallies at about 10-19 down. So now he's really taking a bite into it. Score seems to take a long while to change on these scoreboards.
Yeah, if we've noticed that today, there's seems to be a few glitches with the scoreboards, as is sometimes the case on qualification day. You know, another point. Oh, it's 2014 game point for the German. Lazy return. And a good smash down the line. Straight smash. Winner for Domke. But I've just got the feeling that Rasmus Fladberg will feel, he won't feel too disappointed. No, going into the second game after losing the first, he certainly found a little bit of rhythm towards the end of that first game.
The only thing I'll say is that Dieter Domke is now moving to the end that it's easier to attack on, so that'll be interesting. But it's also easier to hit out, so any sort of flat attacking clears, you'd be wise to sort of really measure them, because the shuttle really is flying either from the net or when it's being attacked.
German coach Holger Hassep talking to Dieter Domke. Some replays of some of the action from the first game. Again, Dieter Domke is taking all the time allotted.
20 seconds. Second game.
So we're back with the second game. Dieter Domke in black nearest the camera. First game to the German, 21-14, but first blood for the Dane in red. A little bit of disappointment for Denmark yesterday evening, of course, going out into soccer. Won't be in the European Championships this coming summer in France. Losing out to Sweden. I know a lot of these Danish boys follow their soccer very passionately.
What I would say is that Rasmus has come out a totally different pace to what he played the first end. So this is how you bite into a player. You really work them and make the rallies count. He looks a different player.
Yeah, as we said, he lost that first game, but he lost it coming off the court, feeling, you know, that he's found a little bit of rhythm. Oh, it's a good stretch from the Dane. Even lifting it into the wind, it was still a long way out. Yeah, he's on his toes. He's very aggressive now on the return of serve. You can see Fladberg certainly trying to lift the tempo of the rallies. Ooh. Super body smash, and I don't think Dieter Domke expected it to come back. He nearly put that net kill outside the tram lines.
I definitely get the impression that the work rate has gone up on from both these players. Really moving to the shuttle.
There's a lot of stake in this match. Yeah, it's only the first round. It's a round of 64. But both these men need to win it. You know, they need something to give them confidence moving forward, because it's been less than illustrious so far this season for both of them. And I think both of them, when they probably saw the draw, really identified an opportunity to win an opening round.
Super defense from his body there, Dieter Domke.
Concentration from Fladberg. Oh, then really an unforced error after doing so much
very good
hard work.
Very good rally. But it was definitely Fladberg that did the work in that rally. Indeed, the Donker's got such good reach that he's can cut so many shuttles out.
Power off the legs, pushing to go around the head with the smash from Fladberg. Many of us mere mortals would have elected just to turn onto the backhand side. Mistimed that shuttle coming off the frame. Good get from Fladberg. It was such a steep angle on the smash from Domke. Three-quarter stick smash.
And he did really well to win that point, didn't he? Because
yeah, he really had no right to win it.
No,
yeah.
Exactly. But you're just seeing Dieter Domke just missing the lines here. He's playing a lot tighter than Fladberg's playing. Fladberg's giving himself very good margin.
Just an update from the adjoining court. Hans-Kristian Vittinghus, the top seed in the men's singles, has lost the first game against Luca Corvée of France. Of course, the French, you know, they've come here. I'm sure they're very, very focused and want to do well and want to prove a point. Certainly Luca Corvée, who is a player that Vittinghus has had problems with before, has taken the first game.
Really nothing in this second set at the moment, but I just get the impression that Fladberg's writing the tactics for this game.
Yeah, there's the interval lead for the Dane, 11-8, and I think Rasmus Fladberg, well worth that interval lead, Ray, came out in the second game. A different player.
Different player, different pace.
Absolutely. Looked a lot more in control and really starting to push Dieter Domke. Yeah, and you can see even with the body language compared to the interval in the first game, it's a little bit more positive now from the Dane. That's the father of Natalia Koch-Rode, who also plays in the women's singles here. I can't remember his first name, but that's her father. It wasn't the sweetest winners Dieter Domke ever played. Nice footwork from Fladberg.
A lot of ground he's covered there. Mm. That's good. Brilliant to get that back.
Great concentration. So run away again. Oh yeah, cross court smash. All in for Domke. Early in the day, we had qualification, of course, and during that qualification, there were a lot of schools here. I think there was a festival in one of the adjoining halls, actually in the velodrome, and a lot of kids here supporting, and I just see OLR Primary School sending in a tweet to say, thank you very much. We had a fantastic time today at the Scottish Open. Certainly was our pleasure having them. Good net from both men. Domke just caught a little bit flat-footed.
Rasmus Fladberg has started to serve short, and it's not easy to serve short to a guy who's as tall as Dieter Domke. Really not easy to, because they're really pressing the net. This sort of rally will really suit Rasmus Fladberg. He's looking to punish Dieter Domke physically, and this is exactly what this does. But for him to get that smash down, it took probably best part of 20 shots, and that's exactly what Rasmus Fladberg wants. Which is hard because a lot of the time it's Rasmus Fladberg that's doing the more work because of Dieter Domke's great reach and being able to cut out so many shuttles.
A good block defense from Fladberg and that body smash off Domke. Yeah, good patience from the German in that rally. Some excellent net. Some perspiration on the floor. Moppers are in. And both men just taking the opportunity to compose themselves. So it's Domke serving, trailing 10-14. The German winning the first, 21-14. Wow. 14.
sharp on that with Rasmus. He was on sprinting blocks there, I think. Very tight game this now, Mark. Which definitely goes in Dieter Donker's favour if it's looking tight.
Yeah, both men just starting to make a few unforced errors. We were starting to get to the business end of the game.
You can certainly see the sheen of sweat on Dieter Donker.
Again, nice smash just down. And the backhand hip of Fladberg, very difficult to defend against. But Rasmus is keeping this 4-point advantage. Just out.
And that's the fast end, and they surprise a number of lifts from the net. That would go out.
You know, Fladberg is pretty much in control, 5-point advantage. Would certainly test him mentally now to see, can he bring this game home?
Getting the push from the net going out, I think this is going to definitely look like a hallmark of a three-setter.
Yeah, certainly has three sets written all over it now. Have to get this line judge to move, just slightly blocking the score down in the top right hand corner. But there it is, second game to Rasmus Fladberg, and I certainly feel, and Ray I think agrees, that he came out a different player at the beginning of the game. He raced in, I think he got a 14-9 ahead, and really there was no way back for Domke at that point. Good second game and a good bounce back from Fladberg.
And I really am expecting Fladberg to come out fast in the third.
Yeah, I'm expecting pretty much more of the same from the Dane. On the adjoining court, Hans-Kristian Vittinghus has taken control of the second game, leading 17-8. After losing the first against Frenchman Lucas Corvée elsewhere. Former champion, Anand Pavar, won game up against Scotland's Kieran Merrilies and winning the second. And Johan Tan has taken the first game 21-14 against Adam Mendrick of Czech Republic. Kieran Merrilies on the adjoining court. Certainly haven't seen much of Kieran this season on the circuit, so I assume he's been suffering a little bit from injury. I know he has been dogged with injury.
Injuries, that's right. And I think he was really looking forward to playing this tournament, but Pawar's not the type of player that he likes to play against. Doesn't give you anything. Everything comes back, and it becomes a bit brutal. Final game,
So we're back with the final game. And it's the first point and the clenched fist of Rasmus Fladberg. Oh, that's a beautiful cross net from Domke. And a smash down the line.
But Dieter Domke probably put about, I don't know, 7 or 8 quality shots in and finally got one through, but it's not easy.
Ah, come on!
I think there was just a little bit of indecision from Dieter. He may have felt that one was starting to drift out. Jump smash from Fladberg, just a little bit flat.
Whoa!
Yeah, and just taking the pace off. Competition is so stiff in Denmark. The likes of Fladberg and Emil Holst and other players like that, you know, fighting for their lives really in the national team. Disappointment on the face of Fladberg certainly felt that one had drifted out. And this is something, and this is an area of the game that Rasmus really needs to work on. Yeah, I think it was just out.
So tight.
Sometimes when something like that goes against him, all of a sudden the concentration goes and he can lose 4 or 5 points in a row. If you're a Rasmus Fladberg fan, it's certainly important that he wins this point. Yeah, he got lucky there. It looked the one he stretched for down the backhand side, looked to be going out.
There were some fabulous shots in that rally, though. I mean, Rasmus Fladberg really got some stuff back. And I think Dieter Domke is really putting quality shots in.
Hans-Kristian Vittinghus taking the second game, 21-18, to level it up one game all against Luca Corvée. And Domke targeting the body of Fladberg.
And really pressing the net. It was so smart, that sort of rally. Perhaps you ought to do that a little bit more. Because I think that in the physical game, there's only going to be one winner here, and that's Fladberg.
Very committed on the return of serve.
It's got great pace when he uses it. Great pace. And I actually think Dieter Domke's done some really good work on his defense here, because, I mean, Fladberg's put in a good smash to his backhand there, and then Dieter Domke was able to put it back in the back two lines, which is not easy to do.
Oh,
great,
yeah.
Shot.
Around the head, cross court.
I know Dieter Domke's tall, but that serve, it was just coming flat across the net, I'm sure of it. It was
again, good smash down the line and then exploding forward for the kill of the net, the German. And you can see, as Ray said, you can see the sheen of sweat on the German. And it's like, it's not particularly warm in this hall.
No. I think the work rate that's going on in that court, and you could probably fire a wind farm.
Plenty of wind around to fire the wind farms. My God, the weather here for the last day or two, and certainly from where I've come in Ireland, has been horrific. Even just getting here for a lot of the players and a lot of the officials, lots of flights diverted, cancelled.
Yeah, well, we were lucky we got you, Mark.
Yeah. Storm, the remnants of Hurricane Barney. The only Barney I ever remember was purple and kind to kill kids. He didn't cancel flights. But anyway, back to the action. And pretty much as expected, a tight third game. 37 minutes on the clock. Smash to the body.
Really putting in great variation of smashes, Dieter Domke.
A cross-court smash, so always dangerous because you leave yourself wide open for the block down the line.
But he's won quite a few points with it.
Yeah, he has, for sure.
And he's won points smashing on the body, and he's won points smashing down Fladberg's backhand side.
And we've even seen a couple of backhand smashes from Domke.
Yeah. But it's that sort of work rate in the rallies where it goes sort of above seven or eight shots that I think that Rasmus Fladberg is just getting the edge in the match.
Now we've got the old school mops here in Scotland this week. And as you can see, the banners with the wording Scotland, the perfect stage, and Scotland has staged many fantastic badminton tournaments in the recent past. This is the fourth edition, of course, of the Scottish Open Grand Prix, formerly a Scottish International Challenge on the Badminton Europe circuit, elevated to Grand Prix status this past 4 years. And then the banner behind, you can see Glasgow2017.com. And this Emirates Arena will be home to the BWF World Championships in 2017. On the 21st to the 27th of August, my birthday. Oh, I missed that one, Ray.
It's rather like the previous one. It's tight, but I'm sure the linesman's got the best view of it. Dieter Domke's really getting success when he's going on Rasmus Fladberg's body, and I'm sure the coach will be saying that to him, to hit the body and press the net, but well, that's what I'd be saying to him anyway. So it's on the body, and then he's straight on it. Very good.
So 40 minutes gone in this men's singles first round here, the Scottish Open Grand Prix. Dieter Domke on screen against Rasmus Fladberg, one game apiece. 11-10 to the German in this deciding set.
Phenomenal rally that, and really Rasmus Fladberg did the right things, but he knocked it off at the net, and the quick reactions of Dieter Domke there got it back into play. Tight third set this. All to play now for the 12-all in the third set. And my guess is that Rasmus Fladberg is trying to extend the rallies. And Dieter Domke is trying to shorten the rallies. Sure, that's going to get the court mopped.
Yeah, probably a welcome break for both men. Tight game, 13-all. Corvey again pulling away from Vittinghus in the third game. Dangerous times for the number one seed, Hans-Kristian Vittinghus. On court number five, the outside court.
If you look at all the matches going on, Mark, there's just not an easy one out there, is it? They're all being so hard fought for.
Yeah, Kieran Merrilee's putting up a valiant fight. Was trailing 11-4 against Anand Pavar. And is now back just trailing 1-15-14. Good fight from the Scot. Back to the action, change of shuttle here. Court number one. Our streaming court.
I think Dieter Domke's got a way through if he plays the right tactics. As has Fladberg, if he can extend the rallies.
Yeah, not the best serve. Easily attacked. Fladberg pushing it back into the body.
Hasn't been called though, has he?
I think Fladberg may have been called for moving.
Prior
to the shuttle, yeah.
Been certainly struck. Looked in his starting blocks there. Actually, they look like they're playing a let.
Yes,
that's
it
unusual.
Is a let.
Yep.
Justice, maybe.
I'm sure if you put a split camera on that, it would have been a fault, in my opinion. But he's upped his pace, and successfully upped his pace.
2 points in a row for the Dane. Just gets his nose in front by 2-15-13 in this deciding set. Yeah, no commitment really in that little loopy drop.
And it was just one step forward for Dieter Domke.
Yeah. Nice cross court smash mid rally from the German. And you can see Domke pushing forward.
Absolutely. There's just nothing in this now. And this is how Domke wants it, really. He wants it nice and tight so that Fladberg's got to go for stuff.
Easy half court smash. But certainly I'm trying to watch Rasmus on the serve, and to me he's moving before the shuttle is addressed.
Which means it'd be right there for a flick if Dieter Domke wanted to put a flick in. Just nothing in this match now. Anyone's game.
Well, that one was certainly out.
So he's putting the pressure on Rasmus, and Rasmus is having to go for his points. He's not so good at that game.
Johan Tan of Belgium advances to the next round. 21-14, 21-18 win over Adam Mendrick. Ah, yeah. Good feat from Fladberg to dig that one out of the body.
It was, because of the right tactics. Oh, net called there.
That's the end of the line for Kieran Merrilies, losing 18-18 to former champion Anand Pavar of India. Little bit of disguise, little bit of slice cross court from Fladberg. Brave shot at match point down.
Certainly was, but Dieter Domke has been using that flick that we mentioned earlier on, Mark. Both trying to take control of the net, so it's another match point for Dieter Domke. Third match point.
Oh,
and he got the error.
Oh, and that could be a card for Fladberg, flinging the racket and the racket going onto the adjoining court. Certainly the umpire won't accept that disappointment for the Dane. But it's Dieter Domke who advances to the next round, and it was he who held his composure at the crucial time. We'll see it here. Straight smash and the fling of the racket. No doubt about it, it was out.
Mark, I might be wrong, but I think that there might have been an upset with Vittinghus.
No, Vittinghus has won.
Has he?
Yeah,
right,
21-16 in the third. He was pushed, Ray, for sure, and he's played Luca Corvée twice before, I remember. I remember once it was in the European Championships in Kazan in Russia, and Corvée, Vittinghus only came through 19-19 in two games, so he struggled against Corvée before. But back to our court, and we can see Dieter Domke leaving victorious, and is the German who marches on to the next round. Disappointment.
But what a super match to put on the TV court. That was...
52 minutes, and both players just talking to each other as they leave the court. Domke advances. He'll play the winner of Vladimir Markov, the seventh seed, and Joel Deuce of England, a qualifier. But for now, we'll take a very short break. Don't go anywhere, we'll be back momentarily with further live coverage from the Scottish Open Grand Prix.